India, there is no provision in Contract Act either for or against the rule. There has been a great divergence of opinion in Indian courts as to how far a stranger to contract can enforce it. There are many decided cases which declares that contract cannot be enforced by a person who is not a party to it, and that the rule laid down in Tweedle versus Atkinson is as much applicable in India as it is in England. However, with the passage of the time, the courts in India have created certain exceptions to the rule, and there are various cases in which it was held that a beneficiary, third person under the trust, family arrangements and the various laws can sue or enforce his rights. Decision in favor of rule of privity of contract. The rule was first applied by the Privy Council in 1911 in Jamnadas versus Ram Avatar, where A borrowed rupees 40,000 by executing a mortgage of a zamindari in favor B. Subsequently, A sold the property to C for rupees 44,000 of the price in order to redeem the mortgage if he thought fit. B sued C for the recovery of the mortgage money, but he could not succeed because he was not a party to an agreement between A and B. The Privy Council held that the undertaking to pay back the mortgagee was given by the defendant to his vendor. The mortgagee has no right to avail himself of that which he was not a party. The purchaser entered into no contract with him, and the purchaser is not personally bound to pay B his mortgage debt. In the opinion of Banking Chief Justice, this seems to be the effect of the Contract Act itself. In Krishnan versus Pamela Bala, his lordship observed, I quote, not only, however, is there nothing in section 2D to encourage the idea that contracts can be enforced by a person who is not a party to contract, but this notion is rigidly excluded by the definition of the promisor and the promisee. In my opinion, it is erroneous to suppose that in India, persons who are not the parties to a contract can be permitted to sue thereupon. Unquote. The Supreme Court of India has expressed itself in favor of the privity rule laid down in Atkinson's case in M.C. Chakku versus State Bank of Travancore. In the present case, the Highland Bank was indebted to the State Bank of Travancore under an overdraft. One M, who was a manager of the Highland Bank, and his father K has guaranteed the repayment of an overdraft. K gifted his properties to the members of his family. The gift deed provided that the liability, if any, should be met by M either from the bank or from the share of the property gifted to him. The State Bank attempted to hold M liable under this provision of the deed, but M was not liable. The Supreme Court held State Bank of Travancore, not being a party to the deed, cannot enforce the covenant and was bound by them. It is a settled law that a person who is not a party to the contract cannot enforce its terms.